are doing very well.
How many of you are doing meditation in those days? Nobody. Everybody is bored. Lifestyle is changed. Huh? So that gives a, you see, that gives an environment where you, my topic is your disease management. If you create a healthy environment of around you, then you are able to find well-being or healthiness of everything. Means supposed to maintain the human system. Today we are talking about your COVID-19, this spread, and whole world is locked down. Because, for what for? Because your immune system cope up with this reacting this. You know there are interference in your system. Interference secreted antiviral proteins that prevents the disease outbreak. Again, if you look into the different aspect, if you see post environment and pathogen. Post environment pathogen. And why in a system disease occurs? Why in a system disease occurs? Can anybody? Why in a system disease occurs? Because if you see, that is post pathogen environment interaction. Clear to all of you?
Yes, sir.
You know, post pathogen environment. If you see, suppose environment is there, maybe a healthy environment or enabling environment, or may not healthy. Just like if you see, Jamuna is clean today. Because of lot of industrial effluents that are going to the Jamuna, it stopped because of lockdown period. So the water quality of Jamuna is improved. Right? Again, if we'll see, maybe the environment, means if we'll see in Kolkata, because of lot of vehicles and other things, people are unable to have a morning walk. Because of carbon dioxide and all this level was going up, so morning walk not is advised. Today, if you'll see, everything is shut down. So there's a drastic change in the environmental quality. Maybe people will study the impact of COVID, maybe all riverine system, many things, man-made activities. So that has been stopped and environment has improved. So the environment is improving, then it indicates the health index of any of the organisms. So that is host. Again, pathogen. If pathogen is present everywhere. You see, COVID-19 was also there. You know, in case of fish lives in your water, aquatic system. Aquatic system, if you see, pathogens are present. Maybe smaller amount, maybe larger amount. But they do not penetrate into the body. Unless otherwise, your immune system is weak. Suppose I will give an example. Suppose you five of you went to a marriage ceremony. Okay? All of you enjoy with the dish like your non-veg dish, maybe your starters, and maybe finally have a mutton curry. Okay, all of you enjoyed and come back and slept in your home. Next day morning, if you'll find three of you have a loose motion characteristics. And two of you are healthy. Because three of you get a disease condition because your intestinal microorganisms, that is E. coli, that are getting multiplied because of they got an unfavorable environment in your systems and that caused to you a loose motion. Again, another two, because their immune system was strong, the microorganisms not allowed to multiply, so they are strong, they do not have a disease. Similarly, in aquatic environment or any of the environment or any of the system, in your organism, maybe fish or shrimp or terrestrial animals, if you look into it, there is a host, pathogen and environmental interactions. The environment is, suppose sometimes the environment is very bad, the pathogens got multiplied, then they attack to the immune system. If your immunity is not strong enough, then pathogens shelter in your body and that got multiplying factors and you become disease. Right? All of you understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. So that is that things. Again, if we'll see, again, what are the systems? Maybe there are factors causing the disease. One is your biotic factor, another is a abiotic factors. No. The biotic factors all may be known as the stressors, the biotic stressors or abiotic stressors. The biotic stressors, if you look into the system, maybe what is? Maybe virus comes into the picture, then comes into the bacteria, then comes into the fungus, then fourth one may be a parasite, parasite of so much in nature. Then if you look into this abiotic factors starts with maybe your DO, ammonia, nitrite, hydrogen sulfide, or pH. These are the critical limiting factors. We do not go to like today you are talking about the heavy metals or other things that have a little end. Other things that are playing a major role in the histopathological changes of the any of the organisms. Then if this is happening into a system, then how you can check into the abiotic factors is totally linked to the water quality parameters or maybe sediment that are playing a major into the water-soil interface. Water and soil interface. Again, there is another quality that is air-water interface, top of this system in a pond, if you look into a pond or large water bodies or maybe a lotic system or maybe a lentic systems. All into look into this synergy in this. Today, we are nowhere. Maybe today I got a picture from Bihar. We have a Khutia mon. And there, this silver carp mortality is going on. Silver carp, because of there is a change in climate, maybe temperature is going too high, then some other disease causing organisms that are multiplying, only grass carp in the system is getting affected. Or silver carp in the system, maybe oxygen level, water level has come down, the silver carp getting affected. And so these are the systems comes when there is also change in the season, change in the rainfall patterns, or maybe sudden cloudy weather, or maybe a sudden rain, any of the environment. So as a fisherman point of view or a farmer point of view, when there is an onset of summer or rainy or winter, so there is a disease pattern in the system also changes. Then how you will address these times? Because many people believes maybe you have some disease, you take some medicine, or maybe a headache, you take some medicine, you will get relief. So similarly, in the water systems, when fish lives in water, in the seasonal changes, maybe there are certain diseases play, or without any disease, many biotic component in one being, there is a abiotic component that triggers the mortality of the fish. Then how will you address this type of mortality? You may advise them, you apply medicine, other things, but that is not the sole solutions that you can check the mortality. But you have to understand the environment and accordingly you have to play how it can help you for combating the diseases, improving the environment, improving the quality of water, improving the sediment quality, and improving the health indices of the fish. Today, if you'll see, just like there is a quote told that prevention is better than cure. So today we are people are talking about the better management practices, BMPs. So today, if you know the history of the fish pond, or you may have a like traceability, people talk about the traceability when there's export oriented things come into the picture. Then similarly, the pond record traceability. Suppose you have a pond history of 10 years, looking into the water changing scenario taking place in the system. Then you can put into the data of the 10 years, being into the iCloud systems, cloud computing systems. Then you can predict the 11th year when your pond health will come in what place. This is the temperature, pH, all these things. What is your pond health conditions? Then accordingly, you can derive a treatment strategy or management strategy to combat the disease conditions. Okay. Will you able to understood or not? Hello?
Yes, sir.
It's okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Any problem?
No, sir.
No problem. Okay. Then if you look into the different disease, I will call take you in the later part. If you look into the different situations, maybe we have a challenges, like if you are Bihar. Bihar is mostly concerned with the chaur, mon systems. Then Bill also, you will see, lot of large wetland system is there. And the species, like you will see, mostly restrict to Indian major curves and some few exotic curves. And if you look into today, there is maybe Rupchan, that is Paku is introducing, then tilapia is coming. Then you will find the Pangasiodon hypothalamus. These are the species in of more interest, and people are now going to the Magur also, then some of the snakehead Chana species. So, and to again, people are addressing like your Amur carp also. So understanding the species and their behavior and the disease pattern that are occurring in a systems, how you can play that systems perfectly, that you can get a good harvest from the fish. Then there are, if you have a, like a, any disease process, then how you have to diagnose the disease, perfect disease you have to diagnose. So diagnosing means you have to know the anatomy and morphology of a fish. Anatomy, you know anatomy of the fish, or morphology means what are, where is your, maybe pectoral fin, pelvic fin, anal fin, caudal fin, scales, skins, then eyes, operculums, then snout. So these are, if you see the external morphology or anatomy, then if you go to the internal anatomy, what are the internal anatomy, maybe your gill, then liver, kidney, intestine, then bone. So all these things, then spleen. So these are, you have to perfectly see when a healthy fish, how it looks. A healthy fish, how it looks, then record this, the what is the healthy index of a fish. Then if you are finding a diseased fish, then simultaneously you this go for the autopsy or necropsy. Then you cut open the body. First you see the what is the clinical signs and symptoms. Suppose if you are not there today, how you should ask the farmers or anybody, they should record in the where, how the fish is moving in the water body. If they are not moving, coming to the surface, taking the air, or simply if you have a single cast net or something, catch the fish, somebody finding, noticing this either things, and what is the percentage of infection again. Suppose if you have a 4-5 times you have netting, cast netting in your pond, you are finding one or two fish that is getting infected, then it is the onset of disease. Disease has just appeared. So generally, therefore, any time a farmers or managers or a student are advised to check the health condition, and if you are working with a composite fish culture, because large water bodies is difficult, but small impoundments, maybe a well-managed ponds, where you can have a, suppose if you are doing today a fry stocking, maybe when it goes to the fingerlings or earlings, you start checking what is happening to the health of the fish. then maybe you have a cast net is the only solution. Every fortnightly or monthly, you will see, maybe every 3 months, you should net the pond, see the percentage of the infections or anything happening. And every time you have to see what is the pH alkalinity generally, if you are not stocking heavily into your pond. If you are stocking heavily in the pond, then ammonia and nitrate conditions is an important factors that will have to be taken into account for the pond health and as well as the fish health. So then fish health, I will address the fish health. First, you have to see the, I told, clinical signs and symptoms. That is, there may be the diagnosis, address means your correct diagnosis. Correct diagnosis, maybe you know, there are 3 levels of diagnosis. That is your level 1 diagnosis. Level 1 diagnosis happens to be from the farmer's point of view. A farmer, just like you know the networking of a government hospital, B.F.Sc, then C.H.C, then district headquarter hospital, then state hospitals, and then medical colleges. So if you go to a B.F.Sc, a doctor, maybe MBBS doctor is sitting, he will see, examine you, ask you cough, sneezing, fever, and see some with BP and other things, and he gives some prescriptions for your fever or any disease. If he does not heal up within 5 days, again he will send to a specialist. He will consult a specialist. Specialist will write you something like your blood testing, ECG, so many things. So level 1 diagnosis means a primary diagnosis is a farmer's point of view at its pond conditions, which mostly deal with the clinical signs and symptoms. So if you see the, what is the clinical signs of symptoms, maybe suppose a pond itself. First symptoms is, suppose the fish comes to the surface of the water and engulfing water, that is one sign. Or it comes to the nearer to the dike where you have some micro vegetations are there, rubbing, or maybe some of the bathing side will be there. And stone and other things are placed, the fish is coming and scratching in its body, or fish is moving in a shoal, group of fish at a time based on the behavior, or fish is coming to the surface, if you throw a stone, it will come into the water. So these are the signs. When you roam around the pond dike, you see this is the things are coming, then you should be assured that the health of the fish is at stake, right? Again, if we'll have a sample cast net, you see the, some of the fish, maybe there is hemorrhages or ulcers, or there is a white spot on the body, or some parasites are moving in the, you can see in your open eyes, and there are some, or maybe the hemorrhages may be small, pinhead-like or diffuse type, or being wound will be there. So these are the some of the clinical signs and symptoms that you can visualize if you have a sample netting. Again, if you bring to the fish, if you do not find anything this way, first one and first two, third one, then you bring to the laboratory, cut open the internal organs, see there are changes in the internal organs. So these are known as the level 1 diagnosis. A farmer or anybody, a manager, that can see what type of disease, what type of infections, or what type of changes that are occurring at the field level. Right? So you understand that is your level 1 diagnosis. Then level 2 diagnosis means you should have something to know, like your, what is the blood parameter, changes in hemoglobin, or anything related to microscope. Maybe you see microscopic observations. So these are the level 2 diagnosis. And level 3 diagnosis, today you know the COVID-19, like real-time PCR, then antibody-based ELISA and other things, electron microscope studies, This type of diagnosis is known as a level 3 diagnosis, where you confirm the etiology, means causative organs of the any disease, then you advise them how to go about this. So these are the three level of diagnosis, which is known, maybe in case of human or in case of animals or in fish. So we classify the diagnosis. So for any of the health workers or students, you should ascertain the diagnosis. Means proper diagnosis leads to the treatment. The treatment will be effective if you have a diagnosis properly. Right? Now you all new, all of you, any doubt? Any doubt? Hello? All are slept or what?
No, sir.
No doubt, sir.
No doubt. No, sir. So you understand now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Okay. So this is okay for you, or any doubt up to this point?
Good morning, sir. This is me, Bhartindu Vimal.
Yeah. Bole Bhartindu.
Sir, there is a little bit question. As you are working in Motihari district, so how can a person manage the large water bodies like reservoirs?
Yeah. Large water bodies managing, first of all, if you see the primary productivity, okay? You have to see what much production you can get in a large water body. Okay. So then again, you have to your stocking. According to your primary productivity, large water body, you are stocking. Again, stocking, yes, not your fingerlings or fry, you can stock. Then you have to stock the advanced fingerling. Then if there is any disease come, so at a certain point of time, because you have to see the healthiness prior to release, you have to disinfect properly. Then sometimes you unfeed and see with some of the, like your non-specific immunostimulant, throw the feed while releasing. Then when it will be, the stocking will be less in a large water body. Even the parasite and other things will be there. It will not cause to the distress to the fish, and fish will grow. Maybe there is a emaciations and less growth will be there, but the fish will grow. Because large water bodies, the fish having a lot of area of swimming, exercise and other things that allow fish to grow. And today what we are seeing also, because maybe there are some old fish, maybe 2 year, 3 year class fish is there, when this parasite and other things, maybe some sewage disposers are doing knowingly or unknowingly, because a lot of water bodies are maybe a trap for all sewage disposers. So people are trying to dispose their household waste or the sewage to this water body. That leads to the DOD problems and gradually some parasiting other infections. So if you know that source is being contaminated or other things, then again if you advise to harvest the fish. Secondly, if there is a fish is very small, then maybe some of this, maybe sanitizer will work, because sanitizer, which is a good healing property of microbial infections, is a lesser, maybe in combination with lime. If we apply maybe 10 kilo, this time in large water body, we cannot go for 80 kilo per acre. We can go for 10 to 20 kilos with the sanitizer, some of the sanitizers locally available. So you want to disinfect, or potassium, sometimes lime, potassium, or maybe betadine in combinations, that will reduce the microbial population in the system. If it is a parasitic populations, it will not allow that much of death. You see the percentage of death. And the fish is attend to maybe 6-8 months culture. You have to reduce the biomass. You have to reduce the biomass, engage the fishermen for fishing. Then you should reduce the biomass. Then you can have a improve the quality. So that way you can see. So these are the strategies to maintain the large water bodies to be clean, safe, and get a good harvest of the fish. Today again, we are advising like your phage stocking, phage harvesting. Suppose you have a pen with you, maybe a captive nursery with you. and you can grow these fish with that. And I think yesterday in the lockdown system in Bengal, we assigned the farmers here fishers because we have stocked 250 kg in a pen. Within a span of 25 days, it has gone to 258 kg. It was 500, just double the growth. So maybe say 8 to 10 gram size were there. Now it is 20 plus. So the desired size, we have got it. So we told that the fisherman direct phone. So you harvest because the water level is coming down and they will be stock in the wetland also. So even a captive nursery pen, if you have phase manner, you have a desired species, you can harvest it and restock it so that the fisherman can get the livelihood throughout the year, and the health means your ecosystem health will be maintained and you will not find any disease problem. Right?
Sir, one thing I have observed while I was as a assistant professor in Birsa Agriculture University, and one sample that has been sent to your research station, the fish was heavily infested with the parasites, the tapeworm. And I think you have got with the sample. So I do not know, and that water bodies is used for the drinking purpose. The municipal water supply is being done from that water bodies, from that dam. So in that point of view, how can we control that parasitic infestation?
You see, so, again you see today, you best of the things you see, zoning. Maybe we do not know whether the parasite is only you have taken from the fish and yes, these large water bodies. We have not zoning out. Maybe if you see, maybe you have to see the history of the water bodies and disposal of water. Maybe sewage, yes, and other things, which site, or maybe organic load. Because all, yes, the water bodies, it is not. Then again, you have to zone it and see the parasitic availability in all the places of these things. If that is the condition, you see this is an alarming condition for the drinking. Again, for the drinking, maybe if you see water bodies, sometimes you use low level of bleaching powder. Maybe we will go high level for cleaning the fish, but low level fish of bleaching powder, like shrimp pond, we use low level of bleaching powder sometimes in molting purpose also. Okay. So maybe that time low level of maybe 2 ppm, 5 ppm bleaching powder, if you use along with the lime, then it will improve the water quality. And that also sometimes kills also your parasite also. When the water quality changes, the ecology changes, you will see the microorganism dynamics of parasite also reduces.
Okay.
So these are the systems you have to see based on the synergy and scenario on the place.
Okay.
And sir, one zone is infested with parasite, then you can block, yes, their side by means and things, and you have a specific treatment strategy. Just like people in COVID-19 lockdown systems, you see how they go for the surveillance pattern. So again, you have to thoroughly make a surveillance pattern of the whole of the reservoirs. See what are the zones and what are the things, what is the disposal, what are the litters coming per day, that multiply all these things, then go for the specific effect for the treatment.
Okay, sir. One last question, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, actually, you have a lot of experience when you are working with the in the district of East Champaran. So, can you tell me about the what kind of infestation you got, prominent infestation, what you got in that region, and what kind of solution you will give with special reference to that in culture of that area, they can take.
You see, East Champaran and other things. Maybe we are working with the 5 wetlands. So each wetlands we have a different management strategy based on again people behavior, how they accept your dialogues, what is the stocking pattern, then what is the productivity. Productivity is one of them, so then discharge, then water level receding. If you see, 2 years back, Sirsamon, you see, sit someone is very difficult to manage because the attitude behavior of the people, harvesting nature, less water, therefore fish growth, because last year the flooding condition, everything, the habitat totally changed again.
Okay.
So again habitat total change, that the person, the leader of that group, he has constructed a farm, you see, motivational factor, and they have stopped the fingerlings also. So accordingly, it doesn't, we just allow them, knowing the capacity, carrying capacity, then we tell them to stop. You see, initially they were getting maybe 17 tons one of the month. So within 1 year, it has just tripled, 51 tons. Again, they divided into two phases because there are two groups. So 100 hectare, maybe they have divided half each other. And again, after dividing their things, they took the things and they have these two groups, they have well managed, competitiveness belief. And if you have large water body, because we don't go for stocking, maybe high stocking, like your ponds in Andhra Pradesh, we are go 8,000. We use only hardly 1,000 to 2,000, what is the carrying capacity productivity. Beyond that, you put stock. And we told them, don't feed also. Because somebody might think that the productivity is less, we start on feeding. Feeding means maybe 1%, sometimes to all these things. But all this strategy you have to see, because large water bodies, the treatment is very costly. We can treat based on that, but it is costly. Because if you are taking it to the aquaculture point of view, 8,000, maybe 1,000 fingerling cost we can afford. If you are going for 2,000 other things, generally we restrict maybe 10 to 15 rupees investment and getting 200 rupees per kilo. So that is the type of investment in a water bodies. So we allow them to do in that way and get more profit out of it.
Okay, sir.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Then we can go for the next step. Presentation. We can go for the next step. I can show you some of the slides.
Yes, sir.
You can see. Then yes, just like what you told. Sharing some of these slides of the some of the presentation, you know. It is visible to you, all
yes,
of you?
Sir. Yeah.
Okay, now we can see some of the emerging fish and shellfish diseases in India, how to prevent and mitigate on this. So this is the thing. So next is, if you see, I told, na, you are just asking that with a fisheries are the major, maybe capture-based fisheries, we are finding that river, wetland, lakes and reservoirs. Then most of the things we want for improving livelihood. So rivers are not stocked, but gradually because of dams and barrages, these are the some of the places drying up in this season and some deeper pools are created. The fish are coming to the deeper pools. Again, the fish are when in the deeper pools, you will see river and fish where we're studying, we find some parasites. But we never see that a disease due to parasite, there is a death. So these are the capture fishery related, maybe wetlands, small reservoirs. But in some wetlands and reservoirs, you will find mortality also. Either this productivity is low, fish is overstocked, or there is some old fish due to some of this oxygen, cloudy or the other things. There is concern. Maybe 2 years back, Andhra Pradesh, in Telangana, in the wet of one of the reservoirs, we find maybe 6 kilo, 7 kilo cutfly mortality was there. So there we have to see, then what are the, because the immune system is going to be weak and fish started multiplying and the parasites started multiplying, so there is a disease. Again, today you will find cage culture is booming. So we are at small and medium and large reservoirs, cage culture is taking a place, and pangasiodon hypothalamus is a pangasius is taking into a major role in the cage culture. Then, so this momentum we'll see, and we have only one species, pangasiodon, and we are trying some alternate species. So maybe that will take in a place, maybe locally preferred species. High value, maybe pangasius, maybe in Bihar, maybe 100 rupees, 120 rupees. But if you will go to the Odisha, maybe 65, 70 rupees farm gate. So So they are not getting. Maybe if we are getting 2-ton production, 3-ton production pangasius, instead of that, if we'll get 600-700 kg of any of the indigenous fish, which is the high value sold at the site. So the today the synergy of the like fishermen or the cooperative society, they can able to sustain the case culture. Then entrepreneurs are also venturing. Maybe for I think 3 days back, I am working with a project. Maybe like aqua hops is coming in Telangana in reservoir, 1,000 kgs. Entrepreneur, maybe a Canadian entrepreneur is venturing into this type of water bodies. So those days are not far away. So maybe if we'll say in our large water bodies, maybe we'll work as a aqua hops. A lot of activities with your processing, then captive nurseries, then all, so everything, feed mills. So maybe big players may jump to play into these things. So then high disease, then if you see this is the things, you may find high disease potential and high rate. And today, if you know, all of you know about One Health program, like antimicrobial resistance pattern, AMR is gaining importance. So because to grow this fish, maybe you have heard about the salmon farming in Norway. So you'll find a lot of antibiotics used in cages also. So if that is the scenario, then how you can go?
Okay.
Again, all of you know the position, Indian position in fish productions and fisheries is a progressive growing sector with the varied resources. If you look into the national fishery policies coming, they have mentioned we are 7% growing annually. And we are 13.4 million metric tons. But if you see 2001 census, we have how many million of fishers doing fishing activity, inland fishers? Maybe 14.5. Still more will be there if we revise data will census data will come. So if into these systems are overexploited, then fisheries of anthropogenic stress, I told, aquatic ecosystem play stress, and maybe this press on the wild fish populations also. So then you will find lot of, today all of you know the tilapia lake virus is coming. TILV is one of the major problem is knocking at the door like emerging pathogens. So these are the spread of new diseases may come. Maybe disease is one of the constraint you will see today. Today we very less people will know about the disease. But after few years, you'll find all it is a major constraint for the fish and shellfish production in the sector of the country. So looking into this aspect that are playing a major role, then I was talking about na diseases. So you know, I have already told there is an infectious disease. Maybe I told be my biotic component and there is a abiotic component. Abiotic component means your non-infectious diseases, maybe due to nutritional, or maybe environmental or a congenital diseases. Then what is the condition? I told you about the host pathogen relationship. This is a, you see, this is the like your Venn diagrams that has been placed here. How your host pathogen and environment takes a major role for playing the this type of disease conditions in any of the environment. I told and I have given you, see what if there is, you could see there is a host and pathogens will be there. There is a column, is a, if you see in a Venn diagram, there is a intersection point, there is no disease. So no disease in all the cases. But in a disease, if you see that it comes into the, means A union B union C, no, A intersection B intersection C. And everything if you see host pathogen environment A, B, C, and you intersect, not union. Union means most of the cases, it's a, like if you see, then if only the portion, a disease portion, the white region on the box. So that is a environment interactive pathway where you can study the disease conditions of these animals. So how you can know that is the, this is the systems that are playing a major role. Again, all of you know the life cycle. What is the life cycle of this? Any of Indian carps or anything fishes? Maybe your egg, maybe spawn, fry, fingerling, advanced fingerling, and adult. So these are the whole process of their stages of life cycle. So all stages you may find the disease condition, but you have to understand which disease is coming and what point of time and which life cycle it is infected. Maybe if you'll see, prior to fingerling or spawn to fry, maybe a nursery pond management. So there are some different diseases. So we'll see what is the later stage, what is coming in the nursery or rearing pond management, what are the major diseases coming and what is the grow out sectors. So these are the life stages of the fish. You all should understand. Then in the all the stages, what are the small micro environment is playing and what are the better environment? All of you know one question. Suppose if you have a 1 kilo of rohu gives 1 lakh egg or 1 lakh spawn. When you go to the fingerling, how much you got? Anybody have idea?
50%.
No. You know, the suppose I take a ardhan pond. Okay. I stock 1 lakh of spawn. What is the survivability? In ardhan pond, generally 25 to 30% survivability, right?
Yes.
Then you only get 25 to 30,000 fry. Again, you know, fry to fingerlings, how much survivability is 50%? Right?
Yes,
so
sir.
Fry to fingerling is 50% survivability in same ardhan pond. Then if you have a 1 lakh spawn with you, you got 25 to 30,000 fry. Then out of that, your 50% again, 12,500 to 15,000 fingerlings you got. So only 12.5 to 15% survival. So that is our in ardhan pond here. So then next is the 85%. If you see, 85% it is a death. Means the death is due to what? Maybe so many causes, so many factors, right? Then again, if you'll see, if you'll go to a cement system, maybe cemented systems, if you'll do this, the survival is going to 60% again. Means you'll get 60,000 fry. 60,000 fry, and equally maybe you will get maybe hardly 10% to 15% maybe prior to fingerling, mortality maybe 45,000. You see, the management strategy, the environment changes, your survivability has gone from 15% to 45%. Again, today we are talking about the RA system. You know, if I stock 100 number of fry, I will get 98 fingerling also. So 98%, if you see, maybe it has gone still better. So your management, water quality, disease addressing problems, all a complex phenomena that is playing a role, your survivabilities and mortality pattern. So these are the some of these things that should look into the how your disease process of biotic or abiotic origins that play an important role for this type of, right? It's clear to all of you? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How many of you are you? How many of you are you listening?
Yes, sir.
Look at this picture. I told something now, that is clinical signs and symptoms play a major role. I told you, right? You see, this will tell you the different clinico-pathological conditions, or that is maybe today people are more concerned in genetics is a phenomics. So I told maybe a phenology, study of your external changes play important role. I have given maybe up to F what the changes may be in gill, muscle, or whole body, eyes, operculum, or ventral side, or the vent, or the tail region. So these are, and somewhere we have been show you some of the spleen, that is enlargement of spleen, or some of the internal changes. So these are the signs and symptoms मैं भी एक काटला रोहू एंड सिल्वर का सो दीज आर द दीज आर ऑल फ्रॉम योर लार्ज वाटर बॉडीज इन द वेटलैंड सिस्टम्स आई एम शोइंग यू इन वेटलैंड सिस्टम्स इफ वी आर encountering also such maybe East Kolkata wetlands or some of these here Moina wetlands is manageable. So these are the water bodies where you can find these type of pathogenic issues that will stress anybody. Again, if you see, I told again you have to understand maybe disease pattern occurrence in throughout the year. Throughout the year. Maybe you will see bottom, I have seen some of the fish like a silver carp and mrigal and Java punti mortality. Number one, you will see in the bottom. Number two, labiovata mortality due to enterobacterial cloacae. Then mortality of tilapia, you will see number three due to tilapia leg virus. Then number four, you will find red spot disease of mrigal also. The number five, gill rot disease of katla, if you see, there is a rotting. The number six, there is a argolous infections also. So on, if we'll see, there are maybe we have given and we have seen, we have noticed here, you see, in a table, if we'll see in the different, like you have taken so many wetland, like Khalsibhil, Kongsarvichar, Lokai Babarbhil, then Borochaini, then your Dali Viri, then Radhavalavchak, so many different systems wetland. So we find in the different wetland, different month, what are the disease conditions that are occurring. So accordingly, we place in the system in a different month, which one pattern, it will not give you the pattern of occurrence of a disease. But if like 3 years, 4 years, 5 years, if you are finding, you can find the pattern of occurrence in your systems. Accordingly, you can also work upon it. Right? So again, I give in a wetland system, then your cage culture system, if you'll see, there is a mortality. If you'll see, the clinical sign is a large wound, hemorrhages is there. Large hemorrhages, if you'll see. So this is also occurred in your wetland system. So that means you find maybe it's a skin hemorrhages are also related to the ulcer. So and because of your subadmittance, water changes and other qualities, then if we'll see, we found some of the bacteria like Aeromonas veroni or Pseudomonas aeruginosa, these bacteria being idle, this is a bacterial disease. Then generally for this, we advise some of the oxytetracycline 100 mg per kg body weight daily for 10 days. So that through feed, because you cannot forecast in this a large water body, we put in four feed, then we can find that things are being cured. So these are the some of the full see, these are the some of the clinical symptoms I am addressing simultaneously. The what are the disease? Again, it found. Again, it's a fungaceous disease, if we'll see. It is again, it is a low water temperature. And sometimes you will see over the time when there is a feeding occurs, large number of fouling organisms are found in the nets of the cages. If you don't clean, you will find some of the disease will occur. So this is a mycosis fungal septicemia is here. And this is fine. So it is again a bacteria identified Aeromonas veroni and Klebsiella pneumonia also. Again, we go for this type of mostly oxytetracycline and sometimes potassium permanganate infections at a rate of 3 to 5 ppm into the just broadcasting. But today, large water body cage, it will not remain for a long time. There will be the effect of medicine will go for a certain time. Then you have to devise some of this strategy to see and treat in the cage, because this antibiotic sometimes all are not taken by the fish also. So you have to see, because a long run, if somebody go maybe after 10, 15 years, again, these water bodies, maybe some concern of antibiotic resistance pattern will also develop. So again, you have to while treating and designing, if we see the safety issues, and it will not that much way hamper the activities, man-made activities in the large water bodies. If we see compared to Telangana and other parts, these large water bodies, the tanks is used for the drinking water purposes also. So you have to see any water body used for the drinking water purpose and other things. So your advisory should go accordingly. Right? Again, you see again some of the disease fish, if you see, it is found in cages, and this is again the high value fishes. That is your mostly favored in Bengal, maybe 600, 700 rupees. This is again a fish which is in catfish in nature. So pabda. So again, we find some of the hemorrhages and pattern in this. So I was showing most of the discussed are the clinical epidemiology or clinical signs and symptoms. That is a predisposing factors for the disease diagnosis. Therefore, I show. Again, if you, so these are the some of the disease pattern which you can understand based on the clinical epidemiology or clinical signs and symptoms of the fish, and that you have an idea that pathogens of different in nature. So this is a generalized versions to bring your insight of your mind that how the disease pattern occurs in a system where you can work upon this. Right, clear? Huh? Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Do you want to continue or will stop and start tomorrow?
Start tomorrow.
I think if I take more time, maybe it will pass off your over the head. It will confuse.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Sir.
It's okay, Premchand Prasad?
Yes, sir. Okay, sir.
You understood or it is difficult?
No, sir. Easy, sir.
Easy?
Yes.
So I didn't go into the deeper insight of each of the systems, but I just bring into the an idea to simplified versions to remember how the disease pattern occurs in the some of the systems. Again, I think if we'll, tomorrow at 11 o'clock we'll come, we can continue this chapter once again. Right?
Okay, sir.
Let's do okay, have... sir. Hello.
Hello.
Hello, student. Yeah. Do you have any question? Hello. Okay, anyways, thank you very much, sir, for sparing your valuable time for our students. And hope we'll get your blessing in future too. Thank you very much, sir. Should we start again 11 a.m. tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
The same time. Tomorrow. Okay, sir. This password and ID will remain same, sir, for tomorrow.
Okay.
Yes, sir. You can use the same ID and password for tomorrow. Okay.
Okay,
we'll see you tomorrow at 11. Okay. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you once again.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.